Welcome to the Grok Shop. In this video, we'll be talking about some of the ways to mitigate spam in the Postfix MTA. So here I'm showing some example spam. This is an extortion spam that's become popular in recent years. So apparently in this particular case, people do actually get hacked, their passwords get discovered, and they become victims of this attack. These started showing up after I had a domain for a few years and decided to start hosting my own email for this domain. So they were probably sending these for quite some time and they weren't actually going anywhere. Needless to say, when I decided to start hosting my own email server for this domain, it became my problem. So let's take a look at how we can deal with these and other types of spam. Now, in order to fight the spam effectively, you're going to have to get intimately familiar with your mail logs. These, of course, live in the var log, mail.log, and associated archive files. So for example, here I've got three log snippets. The one on top is showing the spam log entry of the spam that I was showing earlier. And we can see the spammers populating the envelope from with recorded you, blah, blah, blah. And we see the original two is holly@bracken.net, and bracken.net is that new domain that I added. If you saw my previous Postfix video, you know that I've set everything up to forward to my personal Gmail account for now. That's blacked out here. And we can see the status gets set to sent and the last entry is removed. So it got sent to my personal email and removed from the queue. The bottom two snippets show two more spam attempts, apparently from the same spammer, that were blocked by Postfix using two different techniques. The first technique was rejection based on a reverse hostname lookup failure. And the bottom technique is a mailbox is non-existent failure. So now let's take a look at how to configure these and other spam blocking techniques. Okay, let's start out with some version awareness. This is the command to check your Postfix version. So Postfix version 2.2 introduced the Anvil service. The way Anvil works, there's a time window. They call the Anvil rate time unit, defaults to 60 seconds. And it provides a number of per client metrics that we can use to limit bad actors. So by clamping down on these parameters, we can pretty much mitigate email flood attacks from out of control clients. The first three are all tightly related, so a client can make, in this case, up to 5 errors before getting a 3-second backoff delay in responses, and then after 10 errors, Postfix will just disconnect the client. The defaults for these three are 1 second, 10, and 20 for soft and hard. The last two parameters specify a total client connection count. I have it at 5, the default is 50, and a connection rate limiter, which I have at 20, the default is 0, and that's a limit per the Anvil time window. Okay, so moving on to the SMTP restrictions. So as I showed, I am using Postfix version 3. However, most of these settings should work if you have Postfix version 2.3 or higher. If you're working on a mission critical server, one cool feature of Postfix is you can place warn if reject in front of the restriction that you're thinking to add and sort of test it out, and it'll show in the logs what would happen if you had fully enabled it and didn't have warn if reject in front of the restriction. So sort of a nice non-intrusive way to test out proposed restrictions. If you have clients which will authenticate, be sure to put the permit SSL authenticated in your restriction list. Okay, last but not least, be sure to remember that I've set these restrictions up for my particular scenario, which is a non-mission critical, non-busy server at the moment. And so these are specific to my needs. Everybody will have to customize the restrictions to their own environment and their own needs. But you can think of it maybe as a good starting point or boilerplate restrictions. Okay, hello required means the client should introduce themselves with the hello or e-hello before sending the mail command or any other commands that require e-hello negotiation. The default here is no, so as you don't have any problems with troubled clients that can't do that, but if you don't have that, I would recommend setting it to yes. Okay, next, disable verify command. Basically, verify command can be used to query if addresses exist, and they are abused sometimes for email and login username harvesting. So I definitely recommend setting this to yes, unless you have a particular need otherwise. Okay, by default, if you have an unverified sender and you're rejecting, Postfix will send the verification details for the reason why it failed. Instead of that, you can just have it send some straight text using the unverified sender reject reason. And that parameter is available as of Postfix 2.6. One of the nice things about Postfix is it has this layered approach to restrictions, and you can do some very complex restrictions. And as of Postfix 2.10, the relay restrictions were added, which allow you to set up relay restrictions separate from your other restrictions. The first three are by default. I added defer unauth destination, which means if the destination domain is not in the relay domain list, it'll be deferred. You can also do a reject unauth destination. So to back up just a minute, Postfix has several restriction stages. These stages are processed in a certain order, this stage here being the relay stage. And within each stage, the restrictions are evaluated in the order they're listed. In order for processing to continue within that stage, each line must evaluate to an OK or a Dunno. Otherwise, that's the end of the story for that particular stage. Now you'll see in my main.cf file, I pretty much have these restriction stages listed in the order they occur, except for the relay restrictions, because that was added later. The relay restrictions would be, I believe, before the recipient restrictions and after the sender restrictions. So they are done in order, and the order does matter. However, if you keep the delay reject parameter set to the default of yes, then a lot of the restrictions can be rolled up into the recipient restrictions, but you still want to have a separate relay restrictions and data restrictions. So to be clear, the restriction stages are evaluated in the order shown here, but the restrictions themselves are evaluated in the order you list them in the main.cf file. So in practice, what this means is any restrictions that you have in the client, hello, or sender stages can be moved into the recipient stage, and that's exactly what I've done here. So within the recipient restriction stage, my first restriction is permit my networks, which is actually a whitelist to permit my network, my IP, and any other IPs I put in the my network parameter. Next, I'm telling Postfix I want to reject anything that's not a fully qualified domain name for hello, sender, or recipient, even though in the hello stage, it's technically legal and compliant with the RFC to use an IP address enclosed in square brackets. Okay, next, reject unknown reverse client hostname. This basically means that the reverse DNS has to map to something. A more strict version of this would be reject unknown client hostname, which means the forward and reverse have to match, and it has to be the actual IP of the client. Okay, next I have reject invalid hello host name. That basically means if the client's hello host is malformed, it will be rejected. Of course, you have to have the hello required field that I showed earlier set. Otherwise, they could just go around this. Also benefiting from the hello required is reject unknown hello host name. So if the client's hello host name has no A or MX record, you guessed it, rejected. Okay, next, reject unknown sender domain. So in cases where this postfix is not the final destination, if the mail from domain has no MX or A record, or the MX record is malformed, rejected. Okay, next, reject unknown recipient domain. This works just exactly the same as unknown sender domain, except it's for the RCPT2 domain. Okay, reject unauth destination. Now with 2.10 and higher, I shouldn't have this here. I should have this up in the relay restrictions, and I do. I have the defer one, but I'll probably just get rid of this and change that one to a reject up there. Okay, next I got check recipient access hash. This file is basically for recipients that you want to specially address. In this case, I had some email addresses that were attached to the domain from, I guess, years ago that were still getting email. So I want to make sure that I reject those. Okay, next, check hello access. It's a good idea to have a hash here for the hello checks. Basically, because hello can be spoofed, we want to make sure they're not trying to impersonate our domains, IPs, or local hosts. Okay, next I had to add a check sender access because DraftKings was sending email to a defunct account. I did try to contact them and do it the nice way, but they wouldn't listen. So I went ahead and set up a special reject just for them. If you're still having problems after you've tuned all your postfix restrictions, you can filter with the blacklist server using reject RBL client. For me, I haven't needed that, so I've got them commented out right now. The last little permit at the end is optional. I put it there just to make it clear that if you get to this point, you're permitted, you're getting through. Okay, moving on to data restrictions, I've got reject unauth pipelining. What this does is slow down or stop mail from bulk mail senders who use illegal pipelining or basically speaking out of turn. Quick note about the status or error code. You'll notice that except for the check access hash files, I didn't specify any codes other than the default. And that's generally considered best practice. Unless you really know what you're doing, let Postfix use the defaults. A really nice feature Postfix has is this ability to debug individually specified hosts. And this is how you do that. And I'll show you the file that I set up. It's a regex file. You can do it with a regular hash. But note, this is just a listing. So these fields to the right, I have A, B, and C. They don't mean anything. They're just placeholders. Of course, when you set up your map file, you're going to want to run Postmap on it and let Postfix munge on it and tell you if there's any errors. Also, you can run postmap-q to test your mapping. This is especially helpful with regex, since regex gets kind of messy sometimes. And make sure you've got your mapping set up the way you want it. Besides regex, as I showed, you can do a straight hash, which is just a key value pair map. You can do PCRE, which is like the Perl version of regex. And you can do CIDR. If you run the postconf-m command, it'll show you what all your postfix was compiled with, that type of maps that you can use. Going back to the debug, other than per client or per host, you can also set up verbosity on the Postfix SMTP service just by adding a -v and the master.cf file, like so. Reload your Postfix and you'll see huge amounts of data in there, but it can be quite useful sometimes. So yeah, there you have it. As you can see, Postfix is extremely powerful and flexible in terms of stopping spam in its own right. In fact, so much so, you may not even need to use a third-party spam software tool like Spam Assassin or some of the other point-based systems. There's definitely a lot more capability than just what I showed in this video. So if you're adminning Postfix, I totally recommend spending the time to get to know all of the things that Postfix can do. As always, I'll be providing a lot of reference links. If you're watching this on my blog, just scroll down. Everything you need is below the video. If you're watching this on YouTube, be sure to check out my blog post, which will have all that additional information and make it easy for you to cut and paste and all that good stuff. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you found it helpful. Be sure to let me know what you think. I will be having some more related videos coming up, including a migration from SendMail to Postfix, as well as an in-depth fail-to-ban video. But as far as basic mitigation of spam with Postfix goes, that's how it's done. Thanks for watching.